हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल लर्निंग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सिंगल फेज फुल वेव कंट्रोल कन्वर्टर विथ रेजिस्टिव लोड। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड द मिड पॉइंट कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ फुल वेव कंट्रोल कन्वर्टर। सो इफ यू वांट टू सी दैट वीडियोस यू कैन चेक इन द चैनल प्लेलिस्ट। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड ऑल्सो प्रेस द बेल आइकन सो डेट यू कैन गेट मोर अपडेटेड वीडियोज फ्रॉम हियर। We have studied the classification of single phase control rectifier, which is also called as AC to DC converter, in the previous classes. So in this lecture we are going to see classification of single phase control rectifiers or AC to DC converters according to the level of DC output and type of components used. So according to the level of DC output and type of components used, the single phase control rectifiers are classified into three categories. First one is uncontrolled rectifiers, second one is half controlled rectifiers, and third one is controlled rectifiers. So the uncontrolled rectifier uses only diodes and level of DC output voltage cannot be controlled using this type of rectifiers. Second one is half controlled rectifiers. This semi-converters are also called as half-controlled rectifiers because this type of converters uses mixture of diodes and transistors. That means they use both diodes and transistors in the circuit, and there is a limit for control over the level of DC output voltage in the semi-converters or half-controlled converters. Next one is controlled rectifiers. Controlled rectifiers again divided into two categories. First one is half-wave controlled converters, which we have already discussed in the previous classes, and this semi-converters also we have discussed in the previous classes. And second type of controlled rectifiers is fully controlled rectifiers. So in the half controlled rectifiers, the output signal is controlled for only one half cycle of the input signal, whereas in the fully controlled rectifiers, the output signal is controlled for full half cycle of the AC input signal. These fully controlled rectifiers are again divided into two categories, that is midpoint configuration, which is also called as M2 configuration, and second one is bridge configuration, which is called as B2 configuration. So the controlled rectifier uses only thyristors in their circuit and they have wider control over the level of DC output voltage. So in this lecture we are going to discuss the fully controlled converters. Under this we are going to discuss the bridge configuration. Midpoint configuration we had already discussed in the previous classes. Now we will see the quadrant of operation of half controlled rectifiers and controlled rectifiers. So the half controlled rectifiers are one quadrant operated rectifiers, or they operate in first quadrant. That means the polarity of the DC output voltage and output current is always positive in the semi-converters. And the half controlled converters, which we have discussed in the previous classes, the DC output voltage and output current are of same sign, that is they are positive. Therefore this half controlled rectifiers are also first quadrant rectifiers, or they operate in the first quadrant. These fully controlled rectifiers are two quadrant rectifiers. That means they exhibit two quadrant operation. This is the diagram. Here you can see when the converters operate in the first quadrant, the average DC output voltage and the average DC output current are positive. So they operate in the first quadrant. And when the controlled rectifiers operate in the two quadrant, that means the output DC voltage can take positive value as well as negative value, but the DC output current is always positive, as you can see here. Now let us discuss some important points related to full wave control rectifiers. The output in this type of rectifiers or converters is obtained for full wave cycle of AC input voltage. The polarity of the average DC output voltage can be positive or negative depending upon the value of firing angle alpha. This firing angle is also called as delay angle, and due to the possibility of the polarity reversal, full wave converters can be operated as rectifier as well as inverter. That means the bidirectional power flow is possible in the full wave controlled converters. So we will give the name full wave controlled converters because they can be operated as rectifier or they can be operated as inverter also. They have two modes of operation because bidirectional power flow is possible in this type of full wave controlled converter. So first mode is rectification mode. In the rectification mode, net flow of power is from source to load, that is from AC to DC side. Then second mode is inversion mode. In the inversion mode, net power flow is from load to source, that is from DC to AC side. Now we will discuss full wave bridge converter with resistive load. The circuit consists of 4 SCRs, that is S1, S2, S3, S4 connected in bridge configuration. Second is, in this circuit of full bridge converters, we can connect the resistive load, RL load and RLE load. In the bridge configuration circuits, when S1 SCR and S2 SCR on, then at that time S2 S3 and S4 SCR are off, and when S1 and S2 SCRs are off, then this S3 and S4 SCR will be in the conducting mode. So when one pair of SCR is in on condition, then other pair of SCRs will be in the off condition in this type of full bridge converter. Now let us see the quadrant of operation of the full bridge converter with resistive load. As in this type of converters, the instantaneous load voltage and current both are positive when we are using the resistive load in the full bridge converters. Then the load receives the power from the source and converters works only as rectifier. Thus the circuit of this full bridge converter with resistive load operates in the first quadrant. So this is the first quadrant operation. You can see the average DC output voltage and the average DC output current takes only the positive value. Therefore, this exhibits a first quadrant operation. That means when we talk about full wave bridge converter with resistive load, it will operate in the first quadrant. Not other full bridge converters with RL load or RLE load will work in the first quadrant. Only the full bridge converter with resistive load will work in the first quadrant. Next is modes of operation. This type of bridge converter has 4 modes of operation, as we have studied in the semi converters: mode number 1, mode number 2, mode number 3 and mode number 4. Mode number 1 goes from omega t is equal to alpha to pi. Mode number 2 goes from omega t is equal to pi plus alpha. Mode number 3 goes from omega t is equal to pi plus alpha to 2 pi. And mode number 4 goes from omega t is equal to 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha. First, we will take the first mode of operation. So this is the circuit diagram of full bridge converter with resistive load. Here you can see that 4 SCRs, S1, S2, S3, S4 are connected. This S1 and S2 are connected diagonally with each other, and S3 and S4 are connected diagonally with each other. Okay. And the load voltage is represented by VL. Load current which is flowing through this load resistance is represented by IL. And the input source current is represented by IS. And the input signal voltage is represented by VI here. Now what happens in the first mode of operation, which goes from omega t is equal to alpha to pi? This comes when we have positive half cycle of the AC input signal. So during the positive half cycle of the AC input signal, this A terminal of the AC mains becomes positive, this B terminal of the AC mains becomes negative. This positive will go to the P side of S1 SCR. So this S1 SCR will go into the forward bias condition, and this positive will go to the N side of this S4 SCR. So this S4 SCR will go into the reverse bias condition, and this negative on the B terminal will go to the P side of the S3 SCR. So S3 SCR will go into the reverse bias condition, whereas when this negative will go to the N side of this S2 SCR, this S2 SCR will go into the forward bias condition. So the reverse bias SCR, that is S4 SCR and S3 SCR, will go into the off condition and they will act as open circuit, and the 2 SCR which are in forward bias condition, to these SCRs we can apply the gauge signal to drive them into the on condition. So what happens from omega t is equal to 0 to alpha, this S1 SCR and S2 SCR are in the forward bias condition. So at omega t is equal to alpha, that means at the firing angle, what happens? The S1 and S2 SCR which are in the forward bias condition are given the gate pulse at the gate terminal of these SCRs. So these SCRs will goes into the on condition. That means these both SCRs are given simultaneously trigger pulse so that they can go into the on condition. So at omega t is equal to alpha, what happens? S1 and S2 go into the on condition. So as soon as they starts conducting, they will act as short circuit. This SD and S4 SCR are already in the reverse bias condition, they will act as open circuit. So when we eliminate both these SCRs from the circuit and replace this on SCRs, that means S1 and S2 SCR by short circuit, the circuit diagram will look like this. Now we can find out the load current. This load current will be flowing through this load resistance R here. If we see here from the circuit, this source current and this load current will be equal. That means in this circuit of mode number 1, we have source current is equal to load current. What is the SCR1 and SCR2 current? It will be equal to load current only. So SCR1 is on, therefore the current through it will be equal to load current because they both SCRs connected in series with the load, and S2 SCR is also on, therefore the current through this SCR will also equal to load current. But S3 and S4 SCR are off, therefore the current through this SCRs will be equal to zero. Now we will find out the load voltage. Here we can see that the load voltage will be equal to the source voltage. So the load voltage will be equal to Vi here. Now since we are using the resistive load here, therefore we know that in the resistive load, the voltage across the load and the current through that load will be in phase with each other. So the load voltage and load current will be in phase with each other. That means the shape of the waveform of the load current and load voltage will be same when we are using the resistive load. Next mode of operation is mode 2 operation. This mode 2 operation goes from omega t is equal to pi to pi plus alpha. So during these instances, the negative half cycle of the AC input signal comes into this circuit. So during the negative half cycle of the AC input signal, before instant omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, this A terminal of the AC mains becomes negative, this B terminal of the AC mains becomes positive. Okay, so now this negative will go here, this positive will go here. Okay, so due to this positive, this S3 SCR will go into the forward bias condition, and this S4 SCR will also go into the forward bias condition, whereas this S1 and S2 SCR will go into the reverse bias condition. But we know that until and unless this S4 SCR and this S3 SCR, which are in the forward bias condition, given a trigger pulse at the gate terminal of this SCR, these SCRs will not go into the on condition. That means they will act as in the off state only. Therefore, in this mode of operation, when firing pulse is not given to the forward bias SCR, in instances omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, all the SCRs will act as open circuit. So the circuit diagram in the mode 2 operation will look like this, and all the SCRs will be in the off condition. That means they will act as open circuit. So in this condition, the load voltage will be equal to 0, load current will be equal to 0. Okay, so since the source is disconnected from the load circuit, therefore the source current will also be equal to 0 because in the open circuit no current flows. Now here we can see that all the SCRs are off. That means the current through these SCRs will be equal to 0. We have to take in this condition, no SCR current will flow in this second mode of operation. Now comes to the third mode of operation. This third mode of operation goes from omega t is equal to pi plus alpha to omega t is equal to 2 pi. That means this mode 3 operation also occurs in the negative half cycle of the AC input signal, but after the instant pi plus alpha. So when negative half cycle comes into this circuit, then what happens? This A terminal of the AC mains becomes negative, this B terminal of the AC mains becomes positive. Due to this, this negative will go here, this positive will go here. Okay, so eventually this S1 and S2 SCR will go into the reverse bias condition, and this S3 and S4 SCR will go into the forward bias condition. So before instant omega t is equal to pi plus alpha when these S3 and S4 SCR are in the forward bias condition, but they are not in conducting mode, they will act as open circuit. But at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, these S3 and S4 SCR which are in the forward bias condition are given the trigger pulse at the gate terminal of this SCR. Therefore, these SCRs 1 and S3 will go into the on condition. Okay, so when they go into the conducting mode, they will act as short circuit. So when we eliminate this reverse bias SCRs S1 and S2 from the circuit and replace the S3 and S4 SCR with the short circuit, then the circuit diagram in the mode number 3 operation will look like this. So here we can see that the load current is entering at the load. Therefore, this point of X will be positive, this point of Y will be negative. So in the mode number 1 operation also, the current was entering at this X point and leaving at this Y point. That means the polarity of the load voltage is not changing in the third mode operation also. But when this load current will flow through this S4 SCR and reach to this source, then we can see that the source current direction and the load current direction is opposite to each other. Therefore, in this mode 3 operation, the source current will be equal to minus of load current. So in the mode 3 operation also, we can see that the polarity of the load voltage remains same as the mode number 1 operation. Therefore, the load voltage will be equal to the input signal voltage. Now here in this condition, two SCRs S1 and S2 are off. Therefore, the current through these SCRs will be equal to 0. And since this S4 and S3 SCR are connected in series with this load, therefore the current through this SCR3 will be equal to IL and the current through the SCR4 will be equal to IL. Last mode of operation is mode 4 operation. This mode 4 operation goes from omega t is equal to 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha. That means before next triggering pulse is given to this S1 and S2 SCR, this mode number 4 occurs. So this mode number 4 occurs during the positive half cycle of the AC input signal. Before this instant, omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha. So when positive half cycle come into this circuit, what happens? This A terminal of the AC mains becomes positive, this B terminal of the AC mains becomes negative. Due to this, this S1 SCR will go into the forward bias condition, and when this negative will go here, this S2 SCR will also go into the forward bias condition. But this S3 SCR will go into the reverse bias condition and this S4 SCR will go into the reverse bias condition. Okay, so until and unless we apply the trigger pulse to this forward bias SCRs of S1 and S2, they will not go into the on condition and they will act as in off condition only. Therefore, they will act as open circuit before this instant omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha, at which we will apply the trigger pulse to this forward bias SCRs of S1 and S2. So in this fourth mode of operation, when we have not given the trigger pulse to the forward bias SCR, all the SCRs will act as open circuit because they are in the off condition. So the circuit will look like this in the mode 4 operation. So here you can see that the source is disconnected from the load. Therefore, source current will be equal to 0 in this condition, and the load voltage will be equal to 0 because the source is disconnected from the load, and the load current will also be equal to 0. And since in the mode 4 operation all the SCRs are off, so the current through these SCRs will be taken equal to 0 only. Now we'll understand the output waveforms of the full wave bridge converter with resistive load. This is the input voltage waveform, which is a sinusoidal input signal. It is represented by Vi, and the maximum amplitude of this signal is taken as Vm. So here we can see that the triggering pulses or gate pulses are given to S1 and S2 SCR simultaneously at omega t is equal to alpha, then again at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha. This S3 and S4 SCR are given trigger pulse simultaneously, then at instant omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha, again S1 and S2 are given trigger pulse simultaneously. So in this way, we alternatively give trigger pulse to the pair of SCRs. Now we will see the waveform of the load voltage and load current as we are using here resistive load. Therefore, as I have told you that the load voltage and load current will be in phase with each other. So the waveform of the load voltage and the load current shape will be same. So the shape of the waveform of the load current and load voltage will be same as shown in the figure, but the maximum amplitude of the load voltage will be divided by R when we are using the resistive load. Okay, so at omega t is equal to alpha, when we give a trigger pulse to S1 and S2 SCR, what we have studied, the output voltage or load voltage is equal to input signal voltage. So in this condition, whatever be the input signal, the same shape of the output signal will come across the load also. So same waveform we are drawing from the instant omega t is equal to alpha to pi here. Now since the resistive load is used, the load current waveform shape will be same as the load voltage waveform, but only the maximum amplitude of the signal is divided by R. So at every instant the amplitude of the signal is divided by R. So we are getting this type of waveform of the load current. Okay, now between the instant omega t is equal to pi to pi plus alpha, all the SCRs in the off condition as we have studied in the working. So this is the mode 2 operation. So during the mode 1 operation, we give a trigger pulse to the S1 and S2 SCR and it will go up to omega t is equal to pi. Then we have mode 2 operation. In the mode 2 operation, all the SCRs in the off condition, that means before the triggering pulse is given to the S3 and S4 SCR, all the SCRs will be acting as a open circuit. Therefore, we will not get any load current or load voltage in this mode of operation. The source current will be equal to 0 because the source is disconnected from the load. The SCRs current will also be equal to 0 as we have studied in the mode of operation. So, in the third mode of operation, what happens, S3 and S4 are on because they are trigger at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha. So as soon as they trigger, whatever be the input signal, that will be the output load signal we are getting. And again, since we are using resistive load, the shape of the output waveform, the load voltage and load current will be same. Only the amplitude of the signal is divided by R here. So this mode 3 operation goes from omega t is equal to pi plus alpha to omega t is equal to 2 pi here. Now as we have studied, the source current direction will be opposite to the load current direction. So we are getting this reverse signal because the source current is equal to minus of load current, the mode 3 operation. So when we talk about the SCR currents, since this S3 and S4 SCR are in the conducting mode, so whatever be the load current, that will be the SCR 3 and SCR 4 currents. So we are getting the same waveform of the SCR 3 and SCR 4 currents as we have in the load current. Now in the mode 1 operation, since the SCR 3 and SCR 4 are not conducting, so the current through them equal to 0. And since in the mode 3 operation, SCR 1 and SCR 2 are not conducting, therefore the current will be equal to 0 through them. But in the mode 1 operation, SCR 1 and SCR 2 is conducting, therefore whatever be the load current, that will be equal to the SCR 1 and SCR 2 current because the load is connected in series with this SCR 1 and SCR 2. Okay, now we will see the last mode of operation. In the last mode of operation, what happens, this S1 and S2 SCR is in the forward bias condition, but until and unless they are triggered with a trigger pulse, they will not go into the on condition. Therefore, they will act as open circuit in this mode of operation. So this fourth mode of operation goes from omega t is equal to 2 pi to omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha when all the SCRs are off. So the load current, load voltage, source current and the current through the all the SCRs will be equal to 0 in the fourth mode of operation. And after the fourth mode of operation, again mode number 1 starts. And before the mode number 1 also, we have mode number 4 operation. So these are the output waveforms of the full bridge converter with resistive load. So hope you have understood the topic. Thank you very much for watching and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.